Friend, this is the time to ask questions. We have our senator, Ekweremadu, the wife, right there in jail, and that has been the topic everybody is talking about, or the media. But I'm here to tell you that 10-year jail discussion is not enough. Absolutely not enough. I will tell you what actually landed him in this kind of mess. As a matter of fact, many will likely fall victim of same thing happening to him today. I will also be in position to let you know that this is a pure government setup. Take it from me, as I will prove it to you here. Why we talk about this? I want us to ask a very sensitive question today. Did he actually commit any crime by reason of the heart of a father, of a mom, seeing the daughter being taken away by issue of kidney failure? All of us will do same. So desiring to save the life of their daughter is actually not the reason why they are in jail today. No, except you're a witch or you're a wizard, if you see your own daughter being snatched away by death following kidney failure, if it's within your reach, you must take action. Permit me to tell you, statistically, about 20 million Nigerians are living with kidney-related disease. 20 million. A good percentage of them may end up in chronic kidney failure. Is there any hope for such people? Yes. They have to undergo dialysis pending the time they have opportunity for kidney transplant. And now let's go further to ask a question. Even over there in UK and across the world, or even in Nigeria, is there a provision for somebody to have a kidney transplant or organ transplant done? Yes. All over the world, there is a governing law that permits organ transplant. If you look at Nigerian case study, National Health Act 2014, signed by President Goodluck Jonathan, actually specified in section 51 down to section 58, you will read everything that has to do with organ transplant here in Nigeria. However, if you are thinking of kidney or organ transplant of any kind in Nigeria or abroad, I will be in position to reveal to you certain condition that must be met. It is not transactional. No. You will land here if you don't get this. I will share with you right now. This is where his problem started. His problem started from the issue of backdoor. There was no evidence that even the law was followed. The young man in question, when he was asked, "Are you aware of the donation you want to do?" The guy said, "I don't have any money to donate." And I talk about, "What about the kidney you are to donate?" The guy said, "Where is kidney?" Which means there was no informed consent of any kind. And that is liable to jail. This is important to emphasize because a number of us will also have a challenge like him. Have a challenge like him trying to rescue the daughter. It is not him trying to rescue the daughter that is the problem. That's why, having built a reputation, you don't have to subject it to somebody. "Don't worry, Oga, I will help you." Go professional. If you have a challenge that has to do with kidney transplant, or any organ transplant in line with Nigerian constitution, what you have to do, get in touch with the hospital to deliver the professional and the legal framework that should be able to protect you from this kind of mess. But before I get into that, I want to put it to you that what you are seeing here is a pure government setup. Ask me why I say so. It's a government setup which regrettably himself has been part of that government. Senator Ekweremadu has been in power for, as a matter of fact, Senate Deputy, Senate President and all that for 23 years of our democracy. And you know what? It is so painful, it is so pathetic that in this duration of time, we can boast of one national hospital, a federal institution, where they could be called a center of excellence in healthcare. You can't find one. Why is it so? As a matter of fact, permit me to tell you, having been part of healthcare development in this country, let me tell you, with 10 to 20 million US dollars, let me tell you, you can establish well-equipped standard, international standard hospital. As a matter of fact, looking at two governors, Governor Yesu Wike built a cardiovascular center equipped within 1 year. Also, Governor David Umahi built a teaching hospital equipped within 2 years. There's nothing we could not do in this country, only when the priority is wrong. Today in Nigeria, kidney transplant can be excellently done, And you have a number of procedures people travel abroad to go and do. These things can be done today in Nigeria. Regrettably, Debt Management Office recently told us that the incoming government will inherit 77 trillion naira. You know what? That's approximately taking 500 and basic, should give you about $154 billion. This is in absence of our internally generated revenue, whatever, oil and the rest. Where did this money go? How much contribution has he made in our healthcare system? This is Vanguard newspaper that actually stated categorically primary health centers collapse nationwide. Nationwide collapse. This is it here. How much of such? And it is so painful, very disheartening, and as a matter of fact, a mockery, that somebody in the government will make it a public announcement and traveling abroad for medical checkup, to go and treat malaria, to do this one as a thing of pride. Permit me to tell you something. If I open mouth here now to say, just type amen that any government official that travel abroad for healthcare, may they end up like Ekweremadu, you will see the whole of this meeting will be filled up. For us to understand that Ekweremadu's case should not be swept under the carpet, it should be a wake-up call. A wake-up call. That's why I say it is a government setup, and himself was part of the government that set up this narrative that ended up making him a victim. Can we get it right here? The issue of Senator Ekweremadu should be a wake-up call, even to everyone that know him, even up to the jail. Share this very video to him. Tell him not to give up. Tell him to be in position to dream new. And that dream is that when he comes out of here, he should return back as a crusader of excellent healthcare infrastructure and provision in this country. He should also, if he has the capacity, to build hospitals that is of international standard. We have the capacity to do them. In summary, don't be a victim of our senator and the wife, unfortunately, on things that you can be in position to do right. And the forthcoming government, I plead with you, can this be a wake-up call for all of us to think about building a healthy society capable of saving the people that are here? Flying abroad is to tell the people here you have no hope. We can restore that even in this new dispensation. God bless you. As we share this to everyone, let us build a healthier society.